Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 116. Microsoft at What Next for Windows event announced that the next iteration of computer operating system Windows 11. Similar to every software update, it comes with a host of visual changes including a center-aligned start menu, center-aligned taskbar, icon grid, widgets and more. With Windows 11, Microsoft is also bringing support for Android application via Amazon App Store to Windows. Battlegrounds Mobile India has a ton of pressure with regards to keeping things competitive and fair between the players. As competitive gaming and esports begin to gain strong footing in the country, mobile games like Battlegrounds Mobile India and other Battle Royale titles must make an effort to keep things fair. For as long as competitive and online multiplayer games have existed, so has cheating and gaining an unfair advantage in them. Cheating, hacking or using third-party application to gain advantage not only ruins the game experience for everyone else in the but also affects the game reputation overall. This is why Battlegrounds Mobile India has made a strong effort to curb the use of any sort of third-party applications to gain an unfair advantage. Dark clouds have started hovering over Battlegrounds Mobile India ahead of its release. Recently, several ministers have written to the Prime Minister demanding a ban on the PUBG Mobile alternative, citing data security concerns. Prime Minister Narendra Modi commented the Tychathon 2021 might add to the trouble for Krafton before releasing Battlegrounds Mobile India. The Prime Minister said that most online digital games available in the market today are not based on India's value or concept. These games either promote violence or also cause a mental stress. The PMO's India tweet did not have any mention of Battlegrounds Mobile India. However, based on the recent developments prior to the PM's tweet on June 24th, it could be a cause of concern for Krafton. Microblogging giant Twitter has added the first Indian payment operators to its new monetization feature TipJar. This essentially became the first real way for Indian users to monetize Twitter other than using its ad network. Company announced a partnership with Razorpay which allows Indian creator to accept money for their tweets through UPI, credit and debit cards, net banking and many more. TipJar feature is meant for users to pay popular Twitter users for their tweets and it is also now available to a select group right now. The feature only had global platforms like PayPal, Patreon and others right now. Call of Duty Mobile Season 5 is here. While everyone knew about the upcoming season, we have now confirmed name for it. This time the new season will be called In Deep Water. Although it remains to be seen if the new season brings along with any special modes that involve underwater combat or anything of that sort. As with every season, Call of Duty Mobile Season 5 In Deep Water is also expected to introduce new weapons into the game, while rumors are strong about the introduction of a new map as well. Reliance Industry Limited 44th Annual General Meeting saw a few major announcements right from the addition of new Jio subscribers and the growth of Jio platform. Jio for next 4G affordable smartphone in partnership with Google. The company has also announced that its Jio 5G network, which is 100% homegrown, has successfully demonstrated speeds above 1 gigabits per second and has recently received regulatory approvals for trials, and said that the company is confident that it will be the first to launch full-fledged 5G services in India. Additionally, Mukesh Ambani has also announced the company growth in its retail business, fiber connections, JioMart reception and much more. Here's everything that Reliance Industry announced at annual general meeting in numbers. Starting off with Jio, the largest telecom network in India, has added 37.9 million users in financial year 2021, bringing the total to 425 million users. Now Jio is the world's second biggest telecom operator by subscribers base. The total Jio 4G data consumption last year was around 630 crore GB per month, which is grown a 45% growth in data consumption over the previous year. And Jio has now created the capacity to onboard an 200 million additional 4G users. And Jio Fiber is being used in more than 2 million new premises over the last year. And Jio and Google made Jio Phone Next will be sale on September 10th. And JioMart has registered over 6.5 lakh peak orders in a single day. Reliance to build 4 gigafactories to manufacture and fully integrate all the critical components of its new energy ecosystem focusing on clean energy. There are some few of the numbers on Jio platform. The company growth comes despite of COVID-19 pandemic. The company's consolidated revenue was nearly 540,000 crore. That's a sharp increase in consumer business. It had a net profit of 53,739 crore for the year, which is an higher by 34.8% compared to the previous year. Realme has launched Realme Narzo 30 5G and Realme Narzo 30 4G smartphones in India. Alongside the Narzo series, the Realme also launched Realme Buds Q2 and the Realme Smart TV 32-inch at a virtual event. If we talk about the prices, Realme Narzo 30 4G price in India is at ₹12,499 for the 4GB RAM and a 64GB storage variant. The 6GB RAM and 128GB version of the smartphone has been priced at ₹14,999, whereas the Realme Narzo 30 5G price in India is ₹15,999 for the solo variant of 6GB and 128GB version. The Realme Narzo 30 4G will go on sale in India from June 29th at 12 PM IST, exclusive from Flipkart and Realme's official online store. The Realme Narzo 30 5G first sale will be on June 30th. There is an introductory offer of ₹500 off on the Narzo 30 4G 64GB variant and a Narzo 30 5G during its first sale. If we talk about the Realme TV, the new 32-inch Realme TV comes with a full HD resolution, Dolby audio with 24-watt quad stereo speakers and support for all popular streaming apps. Realme Buds Q2 comes with an active noise cancellation up to 25 decibels, 10mm bass booster driver and a 28 hours playback. The Realme TV price in India is at ₹18,999, while the Realme Buds Q2 cost at ₹2,499. A Realme phone with model number RMX3366 was certified by 3C and TINA certification platforms of China. Some of the tipsters are now claiming that it could be debuting as a Realme GT 5G Master Edition. The Realme GT Master Edition will be having an high-performance imaging flagship phone with a lightweight design. Tecno is focused on entry-level and mid-range devices for emerging markets. To that end, it is relaunching Phantom as a separate sub-brand that will create premium devices, and Phantom comes out swinging. The Phantom X is the first phone by the new brand, and it has a fairly impressive camera hardware both on the front and the back. The triple rear camera stars a 50-megapixel main module and with a 13-megapixel of telephoto lens and a 8-megapixel of ultra-wide-angle lens. The Phantom X has a 48-megapixel selfie camera on the front, which is joined by an 8-megapixel ultra-wide module, and it will be coming up with a 6.7-inch Super AMOLED display. It has a 90Hz panel with 1080p plus resolution and a curved slides. The mark of a premium device for a better or worse, the company even paid for the Gorilla Glass 5 protection on the front and back of the device. The fingerprint reader is built into display that can unlock the phone on 0.4 seconds. Realme sub-brand Deezo will be holding a launch event on July 1st. It is speculated that the company may announce the first Deezo products such as Deezo GoPods, GoPods D and Deezo Watch through the upcoming unveiling event. The company is also expected to announce Deezo Star 500 and Star 300 feature phone, which was recently certified by FCC. An unboxing video of Deezo Star 300 feature phone has appeared on YouTube to reveal what to expect from the device. Samsung Galaxy S22 and Galaxy S22 Plus camera details have been leaked. Samsung Galaxy S22 is tipped to feature a 50-megapixel primary camera, 12-megapixel of ultra-wide-angle lens and a 12-megapixel of telephoto lens. Samsung Galaxy S22 series is expected to launch in early 2022. Xiaomi has launched its first ever accessories for Mi TVs and Redmi TVs in India. This product is a webcam to make video calls to loved ones. It is officially called as Mi TV webcam. The device sports a 2-megapixel sensor with support for 1080-pixel video streaming at 25 frames per second. It has a 71% of field of view and it is limited to fixed focus. The sensor supports image 3D image noise reduction and it can be covered using a built-in privacy shutter when not in use. The device comes with a dual stereo microphone. Xiaomi claims that these far-field mics can pick up noise from 4 meters away, hence it works well with Google Duo as well. The Xiaomi Mi TV webcam cost ₹500 less than the OnePlus TV camera, which is basically the same product. Interested customers can buy it for ₹1,999 Indian rupees. It can be available from Mi.com, Mi Home retail stores and Mi Studio retail stores across India. It will be available starting from June 28, 2021. While TVs with built-in camera have existed for a while, the feature is yet to be a mainstream. The built-in camera allows for video calling on the TVs in addition to extra features such as gesture control and face and body recognition. Samsung, Xiaomi and Huawei are among the manufacturers that offers TV with built-in cameras. However, none of them have launched a model with two cameras, but that will change when Xiaomi announces its next generation smart TV, the Mi TV 6. Xiaomi has been revealing key features of the upcoming flagship TV as the launch date draws closer. Today's feature reveal is that the Mi TV 6 will have dual cameras, 48-megapixel dual camera to be specific, a first for a TV. So far, it has revealed that the TV will have a 4.2.2 surround sound with spatial audio, 100-watt built-in speakers and Wi-Fi 6. It will have a 2 HDMI 2.1 ports and an AMD FreeSync Premium for ultra-low latency while gaming and a design for Xbox certification. And Xiaomi has also confirmed that this TV will use QLED quantum dot technology for its display and will also have a Dolby Vision IQ, a feature that allows the TV automatically adjust to ambient light. The Mi TV 6 flagship TV is scheduled for launch on June 28th in China. At the moment, we do not know if Xiaomi have a plans to launch the TV in other markets as well. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.